You're listening to the audio production of The Lemonade Life, how to fuel success, create happiness, and conquer anything by Zack Friedman. Published by HarperCollins Leadership and read by the author. Please note that you may download an accompanying PDF that provides enhanced materials for this audiobook. To download the PDF, please visit harpercollinsleadership.com/lemonadelifeaudio. To Sarah, Charlie, and Drew, my sunshine and lemonade. Preface. Stop. Do not listen to this book if your life is perfect and you don't need to change a thing. You're looking to get rich overnight. You expect life's problems to go away tomorrow morning. You prefer style over substance. You can't do five simple things. And you don't like lemonade. Control your own destiny or someone else will. Jack Welch. Introduction. Lunch with Warren Buffett. Eat like a six-year-old. It's 12:35 p.m. in Omaha, Nebraska, and I'm having lunch with Warren Buffett. We're eating at Piccolo's, which is one of Buffett's favorite restaurants, and where he and Bill Gates have also dined together. Somehow, Buffett's root beer float is significantly taller, but it goes with the territory. After all, we're on his home turf, and he's Warren Buffett. In 2016, a bidder on eBay paid $3,456,789 to have lunch with the Oracle of Omaha. Today, Buffett is picking up the tab. Earlier that morning at Berkshire Hathaway's headquarters, Buffett graciously hosted me and my classmates from Wharton Business School. For several hours, he openly and directly answered any question we asked, occasionally injecting his sharp sense of humor. Pointing to the Coca-Cola products in the back of the room, Buffett quipped, quote, "Berkshire owns a little over 8% of Coke, so we get the profit on 1 out of 12 cans. I don't care whether you drink it, but just open the cans if you will." Close quote. We all sought to absorb Buffett's infinite wisdom, which we expected would be his take on the economy, investing, and business. The more I listened, however, I realized that the real wisdom was less about business and more about living your life with purpose, on your terms, with the things you enjoy, like a root beer float. Buffett expressed immense gratitude for everything he'd accomplished in his lifetime. He is grateful to be alive. He's not trying to impress anyone or be like everyone else. He maximizes his happiness through his work, his charitable giving, his love of bridge, and his legendary junk food diet, which he has compared to that of a six-year-old. Warren Buffett knows who he is, and he's comfortable being himself. After lunch, Buffett posed for countless photos. I'm not referring to the standard group shot where everyone lines up in rows and he steps in the middle at the last second. For what must have taken nearly 2 hours, he posed for individual pictures with everyone. There were no bodyguards or assistants. He didn't owe us anything, but he couldn't have been kinder or more generous with his time. At the end of our lunch, Buffett walked to his Cadillac and drove off into the Omaha afternoon. While a person is unlikely to forget any part of a day spent with Warren Buffett, a few specifics about the man and the way he approaches life will always stand out to me. He has a sunny outlook. Simply put, Buffett is happy. His long-term outlook on life and business is positive. He's a believer. An open mind means access to more opportunities. He takes calculated risks. As a value investor, Buffett adheres to certain principles that have guided his investment decisions and approach to risk. He especially loves the insurance business, which has taught him how to pay out less than he collects. When you have a set of principles, you already know how to assess risk. He does his own thing. Warren Buffett is not trying to be anyone other than Warren Buffett. He chose Omaha, not New York, and has lived in the same house since 1958, which he purchased for $31,500. He prefers cheeseburgers and root beer floats. The stock market's day-to-day movements don't worry him. He's playing a long game. He said he'd rather be a paperboy than a CEO. There is a certain freedom that comes with independence. He knows what he's good at. Buffett is genuinely good at being an investor, so that's where he's focused his time and energy. Likewise, he doesn't invest in things he doesn't understand. Life is more efficient when you know who you really are. He is a workhorse. Make no mistake, Warren Buffett is a workhorse, not a figurehead who shakes hands and gives speeches. He understands the details, does the analysis, and knows his business inside and out. He reached the pinnacle because he did, and continues to do, the work. There are no shortcuts to greatness, and there is no escaping hard work. I asked myself why Warren Buffett is so successful. Some may say he got lucky, or that times were easier when he was starting out. But financial fortune aside, Warren Buffett is no different from you or me. He is the result of his choices. Like Warren Buffett's, your life today is the result of choices. Some choices you made, while others were made for you. What about your life tomorrow? From the time you wake up to the time you go to sleep, you have an opportunity to define the next day of your life. Every day. That means each day is a new opportunity to choose the life you want. In the next several chapters, we'll discuss in detail how to make better choices that will broaden your perspective, how to take calculated risks, how to break free from the herd mentality, and most importantly, how to inspire action. This book is about the choices we make every day, both big and small, that dictate the life we lead and the people we become. The power to define your life begins with five simple switches. Let's see why. Welcome to the Lemonade Life. Everyone has a shot at greatness. The only person you're destined to become is the person you decide to be. Ralph Waldo Emerson. Chapter 1. Five Switches to Change Your Life. Often, we measure life by annual milestones. Birthdays, anniversaries, the school year. Another year older, time for the New Year's resolution. That's great if you want an annual marker to define your life. Each year, you have at least 365 chances to take control and define your path. Many people ignore this golden opportunity. Why? The reasons are endless. Life gets in the way. Don't have the money, working all the time, busy schedule with the kids, it's too late, I'll do it next year. Every day, you're choosing to live one of two lives, the lemon life or the lemonade life. The lemon life is about settling for something less than your full potential. When you settle, you don't actively control your life path and you allow others to shape your destiny. The lemon life is accepting your life as it is, the status quo as a permanent state. The lemon life is built on excuses, entitlement, chasing, and pretending, instead of actively and substantively making positive changes to reach your desired outcome. It's the difference between an average and an outstanding life. The lemon life means your past life equals your current life equals your future life. However, there's a better path where you can define success and never settle again. It's called the lemonade life. The lemonade life is about leading life on your terms, with purpose and possibility. Purpose is the underlying inspiration for your journey. Possibility is infinite opportunity. The nexus between purpose and possibility is action. When you lead a life with purpose and possibility, you can proactively overcome any circumstances. In the lemonade life, what you did 5 years ago, last week, or earlier today is irrelevant to your future path. The lemonade life means your past life equals your current life, but it doesn't equal your future life. This book is about how to stop passively living the lemon life and to start actively leading the lemonade life. Will you choose to make life happen, or will you let life happen to you? Will you engage in the world to create your legacy, or will you sit back and let others define your legacy for you? Will you live the lemon life or the lemonade life? The answer to that question is based on your ability to do 5 things. Prism: How Lemonade Lifers View the World. This book will teach you how 5 simple changes will empower you to escape the lemon life and start leading the lemonade life. Anyone can make these 5 changes, regardless of where you come from, what you do for a living, or how much money you have. You can think of these changes as 5 internal light switches. We all have these 5 switches, and when activated, they are the secret to maximize potential, fuel success, and lead a happier life. Flipping on these 5 switches will change your outlook and perspective, make you a better decision maker, and give you the power and freedom to control your life. This book will show you how to flip on each switch so you can start achieving success, unleashing your greatness, and creating unlimited potential. So, what are the 5 switches? The 5 switches are a prism, the lens through which lemonade lifers, people like Warren Buffett, view the world. P is for perspective. R is for risk. I is for independence. S is for self-awareness. And M is for motion. When flipped together, these 5 switches will create purpose and possibility in your life. When you switch on perspective, you change your opportunities. When you switch on risk, you change your decision-making. When you switch on independence, you change your freedom. When you switch on self-awareness, you change your self-understanding. When you switch on motion, you change your circumstances. Here's why these 5 switches can bring such monumental change. Switch number 1, P is for perspective. Change your perspective to change your possibilities. Your perspective is your primary lens. Your perspective sets the tone for and shapes what's possible in your life. Too many people are prisoners to a negative perspective, but don't even realize it. But when you have a positive perspective, you see opportunities more clearly. Switch number 2, R is for risk. Understand the rewards of risk to make better decisions. The barriers you create for yourself stymie your progress and limit your opportunities. When you remove these internal roadblocks and better understand the relationship between risk and reward, you clear the path to take more calculated risks and have a more fulfilling life. Switch number 3, I is for independence. Avoid the herd mentality to gain freedom of choice. Independence is often lauded as a desired character trait, but too few embrace it. It's safer to run in groups and find comfort and solidarity in the herd. Independence means rejecting common wisdom and daring to stand alone, even if you're wrong. Independence is the freedom to travel your own path at your pace and on your terms. Switch number 4, S is for self-awareness. Master yourself to master your life. When you self-reflect, you see things you need to see, not necessarily what you want to see. You hear things you need to hear, not necessarily what you want to hear. Honest feedback provides an accurate diagnosis to better understand yourself so you can target the necessary changes to optimize your life. Switch number 5, M is for motion. Make lemonade to change your circumstances. When you make lemonade, you work to create the life you want. You can achieve success with the abilities and tools you already have, so long as you use them to enact change. The people who are most successful, who maximize their potential, and who never settle for something less than their best self, are fundamentally happy. Their secret? The underlying reason why they're happy is that they flipped these five switches. They're not all world leaders, business titans, professional athletes, or Hollywood phenoms. In many cases, they're everyday people who made an affirmative choice to create the happiness they now enjoy. At this point, you might be wondering, how do I flip these five switches? We've all heard the old saying that you can't teach an old dog new tricks. You can't change people when they're set in their ways. You can't make them into who you want them to be or who you hope they will become. The habits, behaviors, and opinions people develop over many years are too ingrained to be changed. It's not even worth trying because you can't change a person, right?
Here's the thing. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.